My name is Dr. Kailash Mantry. I'm a life coach and a mental health consultant. For the last 25 years, we have been researching on more than 50 mental illnesses, which we have been successful in curing. All these 50 mental illnesses, the medical science and the Google shows that these diseases are not curable. Today we'll be talking on obsessive-compulsive disorder. This is the fourth largest mental illness in the world. Now let's understand what is obsessive-compulsive disorder. Now there are three words into it. Obsessive. Obsessive means one-track mind, one repetitive thoughts again and again. Compulsory means uncontrolled helplessness and having no choice. And disorder means it's a mental illness. OCD is a mental illness that causes repetitive and unwanted thoughts or sensations or urge to do something again and again. Now this disease is 100% curable depending on how old the disease is. If the disease is 10 year old, it does not take more than 10 months to cure. If the disease is more than 5 year old, it takes around 5 months to cure the disease. 50% of the OCD patients are curable within a year. Constant negative command to the child, dominating parents and fearful anticipation in the family and doubting nature of the parents and ultimately of the child. There are three types of OCD patients. One, checkers. They always doubt whether the lock is proper or not, whether the door is open or not, whether the gas has been put off or not. They continuously doubt whatever they have done. Second is people who are fearing of germs, diseases, especially fear of death. And the third is hoarders. They keep on collecting things which are useless, like old papers, empty bottles, food containers, etc. Now let's understand the root cause of OCD. There are more than 50 root causes. Some of the common ones we'll discuss now. Fearful person, nervousness, excessive thinking, negative thinking, seriousness, doubts, introvert nature, secretive, family conflicts, family distrust, tension, stress, anger, sadness, anxiety, past bad memories, childhood hardship, perfectionist parent, child abuse, argument in the family, frustrations, etc. Now let's understand the sign and symptoms of OCD. More than necessary fear, more than necessary doubt, more than necessary negative approach, more than necessary thinking, more than necessary perfection, more than necessary guilt, more than necessary precaution, more than necessary seriousness, more than necessary secretive, more than necessary illogical talks, excessive time in taking baths, excessive time hand washing, excessive focus on religion and moral ideas, superstition, excessive sadness and anger, excessive blaming nature, excessive complaining nature, and many such things. Now let's talk about facts and myths about OCD. So first let's discuss the facts. Fact is, it is the fourth largest mental illness affecting people. More than 3% people are affected by this mental illness called OCD. Fact is, it is a higher version of anxiety disorder. Fact is, a person has to be sad and depressed to get this disease. Fact is, it is not in your control. Fact is, it can start at any age. It is a basically family disease. That means there are more than one person responsible for this disease. The person's sleep has to be disturbed. OCD can come at any age. There is no age bar. If the parents have some mental illness, there is more probability of OCD child. OCD patients do things which they do not enjoy, but there is a compulsion. Now let's discuss the myths. Myths means these are not true, but people believe it to be true. So first myth is medication has to be taken. My view is medicine has got no role to play. Second myth is it is a neurological disorder. My view is it is a deep-rooted psychological and emotional disorder. Third myth is it takes years to cure. The truth is within 10 days there are signs of improvement and majority patients get cured within a year. Myth is it is a chemical imbalance. And if it is a chemical imbalance, why doctors are not able to cure the chemical imbalance? Because what they are giving is only chemicals. All medicines are basically chemicals. Truth is, even people who take alcohol, drugs, for some time, there is a chemical imbalance and within 24 hours, they are normal. So it is not true that it is a chemical imbalance. The myth is, it is a hormonal changes which causes OCD. The truth is, yes, this disease comes after the age of 15, but there is no hormonal, there is no cause of hormonal. It is not caused by hormonal changes. Myth is medicines has to be taken. The truth is medicine has got no role to play in curing OCD. And in the last 100 years, not even one patient has been cured through medicines. And nor in the next 100 years, anybody will get cured due to medicines. Let it be allopathy, Ayurvedi, homeopathy or anypathy. Medicines cannot cure OCD patients. Now let's discuss the do's and don'ts for the patients and their family members. An OCD patient must do regular exercises at least for 2 hours. Meditation, pranayam, yoga, morning walk are beneficial. Light food should be preferred. Talk only positive whenever you open your mouth. Share your problems with family and friends. Watch laughter programs, enjoy laughing, enjoy movies, relax, don't take more responsibilities, don't take stress, tension, don't do any job which causes stress and tension, avoid negative people. Advice for parents, don't find mistakes with the patients, don't correct him, don't doubt, stop making him fearful, encourage and appreciate him whenever he does something good. Allow him to lead the life the way he wants. Don't shout, don't complain, don't compare with other children, and spend time with the patients and listen to the patients as much as he wants to speak. Patient is clear as to why he has got OCD, a mental illness, and our job is to remove all the symptoms which he has ticked and he gained confidence. Even the family members who come with the patients, within 10 hours they are hopeful that this disease is curable and some signs of recovery can be seen in these 10 hours. Now let's see what are the present treatments given to the OCD patients. First, medication. They recommend within 10 to 12 weeks of the sign and symptoms, patient should start taking medicines. Second is, you know, family treatment. In the sense, parents should advise the patients what he should do, what he should not do, and the parents should check the patients if he's doing anything wrong. Third is, which is very popular nowadays, and all the patients who come to us have done this third one, which is CBT, Cognitive Behavior Therapy. And the fourth is, OCD patients should mingle with other OCD patients and form a group and share their difficulties. Now all these treatments have failed, have shown no sign of improvement, and thus we don't recommend any of these things. Why OCD should be treated and should not be avoided? Because, you know, you can hide the OCD signs and symptoms while proposing marriage, but the greatest harm is ki if you are a OCD patient, your children are also more likely to have OCD symptoms or any other severe mental illnesses. Thus, don't go into marriage before treating OCD. It is in your interest. Thus, I want to end this video with a great hope that OCD is 100% curable and there is no medicine needed for the treatment. My name is Dr. Kailash Mantry. I am a life coach and a mental health consultant. We are setting up a 1,000-bed mental hospital within a year, and years to come, you know, sufferings and hardships of many people will get reduced through us.